God once again.
Amen.
God is good
all the time.
And all the time.
God is good, and that is nature. Wow.
Wow. Are you happy to be in the house of the Lord?
Yes.
Even me, I'm happy. I'm glad to be here. Okay, I want to request all the viewers who are outside there that you keep sanitizing, keep distance, and then keep the mask on. And God is going to bless you. Okay, we are going to start our service. And we are, first of all, we know who we are. What? Who are we?
We are the children generation that advanced.
And what are our values?
Our values are to know God, to love God, and to obey God.
And what is our motto?
Our motto is, let the children come to me, and do not forbid them.
Which is the book of?
James chapter
4. Mark chapter 10, verse 14. Okay, what is our motto?
Our motto is,
let the children come to me, do not forbid from them. Which is the book of?
Mark chapter 10, verse 14.
Okay, you are going to start with the topic talk today. It is about prayer. We should be praying effectively. We should be praying
effectively.
Yes, and our Bible reading will come from the book of Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. Who is going to lead for us? Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. Sophie?
Our reading comes from the book of Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, and it says, don't worry about anything, but in all your prayers, ask God for what you need, always asking Him with a thankful heart. That's the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Proper, Sophie. Yes, the Bible says, do not be anxious about anything. It is about being praying for everything in prayer and petition with thanksgiving, that you should represent your request to God. So, by being anxious, it is about do not worry. Now, do not worry about anything. So, there is the word that says, the word act, which comes from that word. Act, it means number A, adoration. Number C, confession. Number T, thanksgiving. Number S, supplication. So, number one, A for adoration. When you want to adore God, you need first of all to worship Him. You know who He is. You first of all adore Him. You say that He is Jehovah Jireh, He is Jehovah Elohim, He is El Shaddai, He is Ebenezer, like that. When you want to confess, you confess your sins to God because He died on the cross because of our sins. You have already been forgiven. Then thanksgiving. Give thanks to God. There is a verse that says, give thanks to God for He is good, for His love endures forever. Just be giving thanks to God every day. Now, number S is supplication. He is able to supply all your needs. If you want to pray for someone, maybe someone who is sick in the hospital, He is able to heal that person. Just have faith, because that need is already known unto God. He already knows that need. Then as you pray, just remember those words. Do you know those words? Act means. Do you know those words?
Yes.
Say all of them.
A stands for adoration, yes. C stands for confession,
yes.
T stands for thanksgiving, and S stands for supplication.
Now we know how to pray now. Yes?
Yes.
Now we go to direct to the question because we know how to pray. Now question number one, what is prayer? Yes?
My name is Patience Amoy from St. Alban, Makadara, and the answer is talking to God.
Prayer is talking to God. Clap for her. Number two, are you praying for our nation, the church, the family, and the leadership of the church, and the leadership of the nation, and ourselves, and those people who are affected in Corona?
Yes? I am in St. Alban. The answer is yes.
Good. Clap for Jerry. Number three, is the prayer of a righteous man powerful and effective? The answer is?
My name is Rebecca Grace from SUK St. Alban. The answer is yes.
And which Bible verse?
From James chapter 4 verse 16.
And which says?
It says, the prayer of a righteous man is powerful and effective.
Prayer for Rebecca. Number 4. What does the name Acts mean? Yes?
My name is Ida from St. Alban's Church. And the answer is, A stands for adoration, C stands for confession, T stands for thanksgiving, and S stands for supplication.
Good, clap for her. Then we go to answer number 5. Why is it prayer unimportant? Why is it prayer unimportant? Sophie?
The answer is, it makes our relationship with God stronger.
It makes our relationship with God stronger. Good, clap for her. Yes, we go to the next presentation, which is memory verse. Do you know what is Bible?
Yes.
The Bible is?
The word of God.
The Bible is the word of God. And we are going to start with the first one. The first one is? The memory verse, you know, the first one, yes?
My memory verse comes from the book of Matthew chapter 7 verse 7, and it says, ask and you receive, seek and you find, knock and the door shall be opened unto you.
Good, clap for her. The second one, yes?
Philippians 4:4, it says, rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice.
Good, clap for her. Another memory verse, yes?
Memory verse comes from the book of James chapter 4 verse 16, and it says a prayer of a righteous man is powerful and effectively.
Good, clap for her. The last one. Yes, Sophie?
Second Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14, and it says, if they pray to me and repent and turn away from the evil they have been doing, I will hear them in heaven and forgive their sins and make their land prosperous again.
Good, clap for Sophie. Wow, we are so going to read Luke chapter 11, verse 2 and 4. We are going to say it, the Lord's Prayer. Okay?
Yes.
And let's say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Pray for ourselves. Then we go to the last presentation, which is the tongue twisters. In Kikuyu, we say the vioraneme. Okay, number one. Who can say the tongue twister? Yes?
Shoshohe shiringi nyanya diga ure dhuti nyanya. He shoshohe shiringi nyanya diga ure dhuti nyanya. Nigogo shokeria shiringi nyanya dhai nyanya. Shoshohe shiringi nyanya diga ure dhuti nyanya. Nigogo shokeria shiringi nyanya dhai nyanya. Shoshohe shiringi nyanya diga ure dhuti nyanya. Nigogo shokeria shiringi nyanya dhai nyanya.
Good, clap for her. The last one.
If a kisi can, I found a kisi kissing a kisi, where can take kiss a kisi, if a kisi can kiss a kisi. I found a kisi kissing a kisi, where can take kiss a kisi, if a kisi can kiss a kisi.
Good, clap for her. Okay, this has come to an end of our readings and now of our class. May God bless you. Now I'm going to give you homework, which is in the book of James chapter 5 verse 16. Go and lead outside. Go and lead, and God is going to bless you. You're going to meet once again next Saturday, and God, I know God will keep you. Okay, you are going to say the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ,
and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Say bye to the viewers.
Bye.
Till we meet again. God bless you.